What's up, guys? Welcome to the channel. My name's Anthony, if it's your first time stopping by, and today we're going to do a couple things. So first, we're going to talk a little bit about Bitcoin, even though this is a Chainlink technical analysis video, because the price of Chainlink and the price of altcoins in general are going to be tied to Bitcoin. So we're going to talk about some macro factors, namely the coronavirus and the surge in cases that we're starting to see in certain areas of the world, and a potential second wave that could be coming. So we're going to kind of play a game of what if. I'm going to give you some worst case scenarios. I'm going to tell you right off the bat, I don't think the bleeding is done yet. I think we could be seeing some more downside in the cryptocurrency markets, potentially a lot of downside. So I want you to be prepared for that. And that's why I wrote that in the thumbnail of this video. But let's get into it. And at the time of this recording, Bitcoin is trading at $10,484, down 3.8%, almost 4% on the day. But as we take a scroll through many of the top, almost literally all of them, of the top 30, top 40, almost all projects in the top 50 are down over the last 24 hours, and Chainlink is no exception, now trading at $8.90 the time of this recording. So we're going to talk about where we could see a bounce, levels of support, and of course, what would have to happen for this thing to finally break out and start seeing some upwards price movement. Because if you bought in high, if you bought in around $16 or $17, of course, if you're still holding, you're feeling some pain right now. So we're going to talk about what might happen. And if you're serious about including cryptocurrency in your overall wealth building strategy, this is the channel for you. On this channel, we cover crypto news videos, technical analysis videos, and also crypto project reviews. So consider subscribing. And the first article that I want to go over with you guys today is from CoinDesk, and it's titled "Bitcoin Down as Stocks Fall Over European Coronavirus Fears." Yes, I'm talking about the coronavirus. We could be talking about it for quite some time. If you remember back in February and March, of course, I don't have to mention, if you've been in crypto that long, the really negative impact that coronavirus had not only on equities markets and futures markets all over the world and the global economy, but also in cryptocurrency. So let's just go over some of the facts here. There are a whole bunch, but I highlighted a few for us. So a decline in European stocks and US stock futures and a rise in the US dollar look to be weighing over the top of cryptocurrency by market cap. So when things get bad, there is a tendency historically for people to flee to the dollar. They will exit the markets and flee to the dollar. And I know it's counterintuitive. If you're a crypto evangelist like I am, you would think, wouldn't they flee to gold? Wouldn't they flee to crypto? Well, yes. And we did see major rises in gold this year. We saw major rises in cryptocurrency this year. But that doesn't happen on the onset of the decline or the crash, so to speak. And you can see that right here. Obviously, this is back in March, and we saw this huge fall off from $10,500, which, by the way, is right around where we are right now, all the way down to $4,000. But the more important thing is we fell down to this historical trend line, which is right around $4,800. I'm not saying cryptocurrency and Bitcoin itself is going to fall that low again. I'm saying it's a possibility that you need to be prepared for it. Also, the epidemic is doubling roughly every 7 days in the UK, and if the trend continues, there would be about 50,000 new cases per day by mid-October, according to British government's chief scientific advisor. And I know in America, we are approaching, and if not, maybe we actually already hit it today, that 200,000 people who have died over coronavirus. So that is a historic and unfortunate milestone that could play into the markets moving forward and could at least play into the fear that people have. Bitcoin could suffer a bigger drop if the risk aversion worsens, triggering a dash for the US dollar, which I just mentioned, a global reserve currency. Because remember, the US dollar, if you're a US citizen like me, it's not just our currency, it is the global reserve currency. Right? It could be something similar as what happened in March. And also what's been happening, a rise in the flow of coins from miner wallets to exchanges. So people are taking their Bitcoin from their wallets out of cold storage and moving them to exchanges. And that is not a good thing. If people are taking them out of cold storage and they're getting them on exchanges, that means they're potentially looking to liquidate, potentially getting out of Bitcoin, moving to cash, maybe moving to stable coins. So this could all, I don't want to say spell disaster, but could have negative implications. And we need to be aware of it. I want you to be informed. And that's part of the reason I make these videos for us. So that's the first thing I wanted to say in regards to Bitcoin and the macro environment that we are living in right now during this unprecedented pandemic. So what does all this mean for Chainlink and the price of the asset? Well, in my recent videos, I've been talking about how $10 would be a very critical support point. But as you can see, over the last 2 days, we have fallen below that. And there's not too much positive news on the charts here, guys. So, you know, if you're thinking about buying the dip right now, my advice, it's not financial advice, but personally, I would suggest that you wait, because just looking at these candles and looking at the pattern, I mean, it's just a line downward. So what we really need to wait for, and what I want you to be waiting for, is to get to this white diagonal line. This is the current downtrend. It is certainly a short-term downtrend, which kind of started back in August 20, but it is severe. You know, this is definitely moving. You can't say we are consolidating. If anything, we're actually capitulating right now, and it's kind of getting ugly. Also want to point out this orange line. This is the 50-day moving average, and you can see we've fallen below that. So by definition, we are no longer in a bull market. Which is bad news. I know that. You know, some of you guys are going to give this video the thumbs down or whatever, and that's fine. But I'm just here to bring you the truth, as I always am. I'm not one of those YouTubers who just make videos to pump you up. I'm here to be real with you. That's what I do on this channel. So how low could this go? We've got a few different levels I want to talk to you about. So the first one right here is where we're currently sitting. You can see we had this support level here. We had historic support here back in July of this year. Right, we had a couple different times that this level really came in as support, and that is $8.95, which is right about where we're trading right now. So first thing we want to look for this level to hold. If it falls lower, the next serious level of support, and again, you're not going to like this news, but it's $7, right? That's the bottom of this parallel channel that we were watching for a few weeks back in July. So it's possible we could fall down to $7. If it gets uglier than that, we've got the long-term uptrend support level here, which at the moment is at $5.66. So I'm not saying the price of Chainlink will fall this low, but I am saying it's possible if this downtrend continues, obviously. And just think about this. You know, at this point, when the Chainlink was $16 and I was saying, guys, get ready for a correction. You know, we might not rise right back. In my last video, I said, we might not rise back to $20 and you have to be prepared for that. Well, you know, now this is happening. Now we have these macro forces weighing down on the market. So even if the fundamentals of Chainlink and a lot of these crypto assets are strong, like I'm so bullish on a lot of these DeFi projects. Yearn Finance is great. You guys know I'm bullish on Aave. I made a video on that. I made a few videos on that. So there's a lot to be excited about in cryptocurrency, but none of that's going to matter if the whole market is crashing. And that's what I want you to understand. We'll talk about how to prepare also. Now, to break out of this, we want to see it break past this white line, which at the moment, if it grows right back up, we have to break past, let's say, $10.75 or $11. If you can see it get past that, stay there. But really, we need to get above this 50-day moving average, which is all the way up at $13, which from the price we're trading at now, I mean, let's just take a look at it. We are 50% down from that price, from where we're trading right now. So we need a 50% move upwards just to break out of this current downtrend. The good news is, because there is a little bit of good news, we are getting near oversold territory. We are just at, we're sitting right now at 32. Once we get into 30, and certainly if we fall down to 20, we are definitely oversold. Chainlink historically, once we get to these low levels, we start to move back up, you know, so we could be looking at a bounce in the short-term future. But again, if I had to say I'm bullish or bearish, I don't think it goes without saying right now, I'm definitely bearish at the moment. So what should you do with your link right now? Well, there's a couple things. If you're holding it and you got it at a good price, You can continue holding it, and that's fine. Just not expecting big games in the short future, the short-term future. The other thing you could do, and I definitely want to say this to all my subscribers, is you could be hoarding cash, okay? Just as you get your paychecks over the next couple weeks and next month or so, you can put them to the side and just be ready. Be ready to deploy that capital in cryptocurrency when you get a feeling that we might be near bottom. Of course, I'll make update videos letting you know what that's going to look like for Chainlink and what I'm doing. Of course, I'm looking to do the same thing. I am actually hoping we see another crash in the stock market. Of course, I do not wish the illness of the coronavirus on anybody in this world, but from a financial standpoint, I'm going to be ready. And if the price drops of the equities markets, I'm going to deploy some capital there. I'm going to deploy some capital in the cryptocurrency markets. And I'm going to be well diversified. Because remember, this wealth building game that we're all playing, by the way, it's just a game. It involves diversification and it involves multiple markets. And it's important to kind of watch everything. But I think above all, it is important to be ready. I'm going to ask you to like the video if you found value in this content. Again, subscribe to the channel. Never invest more than you can afford to lose in cryptocurrency. And I'll see you in the next one.